Spending some time here on Property Source today with Bruce Briggs. He is the owner of LeRoy Hearth and Home. Their website is leroyhearthandhome.com, if I'm not mistaken.
Correct.
And you can get everything. Is the word and? You got to write out the word and.
You got to write out the word and.
Okay. Yes. LeRoyHearthandHome.com. It's quite a website, as Pat was just mentioning during the break.
Yeah, you got a lot of products. I'm excited about it because I think you may have a solution for me.
Hopefully.
I've got an issue.
Okay.
One of many. My family room has this large fireplace that has a double wide opening. One half of it was a wood burning fireplace originally. The other, right adjacent to it, all going up into the same flue. If you can visualize, all in the same hearth and the same fireplace brick, there's a grill in there.
Okay.
A charcoal grill. Mm-hmm. Now, 15 years ago, the previous owner installed a gas fireplace in that wood part and put the gas. You guys would have done something similar. You would have installed the gas pipes going up out to the chimney.
The liner system.
The liners. Correct. That's it. Thank you. But they capped it off at the top, so I can't use that grill. Number one, that fireplace costs me a fortune to heat my family room. It does a beautiful job, but it costs a living fortune. It doubles my gas bill in the winter when I use it. Number two, I want a vent so I can use stuff a vent in that brick fireplace in there somewhere where I can vent out and use that grill when I'm watching the Bills games on Sundays.
Which is something he never did until this year.
But yeah, exactly.
Now all of a sudden he wants a grill in the living room. What is going on?
Did you follow all that?
I did. A tough challenge because the rule code is that you cannot vent two separate appliances, especially two separate fuel appliances, into the same chimney. If that truly is one flue going up there and we've got a gas appliance, and is it grill gas, or are you burning wood or charcoal in the grill portion?
That's correct. Currently, just a grill,
yeah,
brick, you know, fireplace.
Yeah, technically,
charcoal
cannot mix.
Can't mix
different flue gases into the same chimney.
What if you had some sort of a hood vent that I could come into your showroom, look at, and say, "Man, that looks cool. I'm going to have that installed and vent it straight out the back or something. Blow a hole in the bricks. I don't know.
Nothing that I'm aware of.
God, can I bribe you off the air?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
off the air, we'll figure something out.
Or better yet, have him come down and take a look at it.
There you go.
Wow, yeah. We got to have brains in the room, too.
That's right.
That's beautiful.
LeRoy Hearth and Home. The website is leroyhearthandhome.com. We have a link to their website as well at propertysourceradio.com. Why can't you vent two appliances into one chimney?
Well, first of all, it's cold, but secondly, if you... And depending on the situation, you get those appliances working against each other. One could conceivably vent through the other one rather than venting up the flue. Mm. So code is you just cannot vent two separate appliances into the same.
So it's a good idea.
Could it cause a fire or like explode if you've got, you know,
wouldn't necessarily explode, but definitely could vent back into the home. And we're talking about a gas appliance. We're talking about gases that could.
Okay.
Kill you or make you sick.
All right. Well, let's change the subject just a touch.
Yeah,
same.
Getting away from getting sick and exploding.
Exactly. Yeah. Yeah. Same application, but that 15-ish year old existing gas fireplace insert that was installed. Mm-hmm. Can I get something that's not so expensive to run? I mean, that heats a room.
Absolutely. Chances are that may have been a B-vent or an atmospherically vented unit as opposed to the direct vent fireplace inserts that we're using today, which are quite a bit more efficient.
Hmm.
I mean, great strides have been made in the last 15, 20 years, not only in the gas appliances, but the wood and pellet as well. So they're a lot more efficient than they were 15 years ago. And I would think that any of the newer inserts would be more efficient than what you have.
Okay. That was my biggest beef because I turn that thing on in 1 month, it'll crank the bill from $300 to $550, and that's just the gas. You know?
Well, correct me if I'm wrong, but the technology has improved considerably since the first inserts came out. There was like when they first came out, there was an issue with if they weren't hooked up properly, you'd have gas coming into your home, and people were getting sick and stuff like that. And they've kind of come a long way as far as that goes. People are using them for their heating now because it's so expensive.
Absolutely. The technology, the direct vent technology really is what did it. We're pulling all of our combustion air down from the top of the chimney as well as exhausting our gases, two separate liner systems that go in. And they're just a lot more efficient than they were 10 or 15 years ago. And you're absolutely right. The technology has changed dramatically.
And the best thing to do is if you have any questions about your specific application, maybe have you'd come out to someone's home and take a look for them?
Oh, absolutely. Once we've talked to a customer and find out what their needs are, and then we do a site visit where we examine, especially in a case like yours where it's a little bit not the norm.
Yep.
We really want to see it and see what's going on there. But we do a site visit on all of our jobs before we give a final quote so that, you know, everybody knows what's going on and, and we can do it properly.
What are some of the other trends that you've seen in your line of work?
Well, inserts have always been strong. Yeah. Wooden pellet is up and down based on the price of fuel oil, quite honestly.
Mm-hmm.
The price of a barrel goes up and we get a lot of wooden pellet customers. But that's steady. But it's been gas. The new home construction in the last couple of years has been way off. We've seen a little bit more remodeling this year, a few more new homes. They tend to be bigger homes with multiple fireplaces, but that's really been the trend.
A lot of new construction building these fireplaces have the gas inserts, or is it, or the inserts in general, or is it something that, as you kind of indicated, people who have existing situations want to change to?
New construction is a gas fireplace, a little bit different than the insert, same concept. But yes, if a new home is being built, more often than not, they're putting in gas fireplaces as opposed to wood.
So the old fireplace is is it a thing of the past? Is it will my kid, when he's 50, say, I remember the days when we had fireplaces?
We still have some wood burners, and we still install some high-efficiency wood-burning fireplaces. Yeah. But not very many of the old masonry fireplaces in new homes anymore.
That's a shame. That's because of the cost, I'm sure.
Cost and efficiency.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Efficiency is key.
It sure is.
Yeah, and you said that one of these gas inserts has pretty good fuel efficiency.
Yeah, they're in the 80s, 80%, some in the high 80s.
Yeah.
Plus, it keeps like the heat from escaping. I remember when I was a kid, my grandfather had a fireplace, wood burning in his living room. And if you would just walk by it, it was cold. There's cold air coming out of it in the wintertime, you know? So I'm assuming that it's got to be way better for your heating bills and everything else because you don't have that air going right up and out.
Yeah,
there's sealed combustion, so it eliminates all those cold air problems. That's where a lot of the efficiencies come from.
Get in touch with Bruce and his gang at LeRoy Hearth and Home. Phone number?
585-502-0139.
One more time?
585-502-0139.
The website is LeRoyHearthandHome.com, and we have a link for you at PropertySourceRadio.com. Are you a Bills fan?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah?
Yeah, bigger Sabres fan, but
Sabres,
enjoy the Bills very much.
Sabres' first game it was last night. They played in Finland.
Their season opener is Friday in Finland. It's pretty exciting to be overseas.
Well, we're going to get to Pat's Bills prediction. It's coming up. You want to make a prediction on the Eagles game?
That's a tough one.
Michael Vick.
Vick is tough, and I'm afraid the Bills' defense certainly is just not strong enough.
A little bit exposed last week, don't you think,
against
Cincinnati?
I think so. I think that Michael Vick will hurt the Bills' defense.
Well, stick around. We will compare your prediction with Pat Coyne's. For what it's worth, we continue on Property Source Radio. We're here till 10 o'clock. That's when we'll get back to ESPN, so stay with us for a few more minutes. Property Source Radio, Sports Radio 950 ESPN, and PropertySourceRadio.com.